We have been constantly developing our software calibrations with RacingLine for the EA888 Gen 4 Continental Turbo platform using our Mark 8 Golf R and T-Roc R as well. This car has seen almost 1,000 dyno runs in that period, and we are excited to announce the brand new E85 calibrations for the Australian market. Unlike the previous generation of Golf, the Mark 8 does not need any modification to the fuel system in order to run straight E85. This means that running E85 is incredibly cost effective and delivers amazing results. In this video, I will walk you through how to switch your fuel over and use RacingLine's PDM to run our new E85 calibrations. In addition to the PDM, you're going to need a laptop or smartphone compatible with the RacingLine software. You will also need a battery charger capable of supporting the voltage during the flashing procedure. We also recommend an ethanol test kit or ethanol sensor, a couple of jerry cans, and either VCDS, OBD11, or another diagnostics tool that can run basic settings. Because our Golf R already has a full tank of BP98 fuel in it, I'm going to be using VCDS to drain the fuel tank. Loosening this bolt here gives you more access to the fuel line. The fuel line may be pressurized, so repair some cloth underneath it to catch excess fuel. Unclip the fuel line from the intake manifold. Then you can push this fitting inwards, squeeze the tabs and pull it off. The fuel line removed, we can now bring it out from under this coolant line and hang it over the side of the vehicle. I have connected our battery charger and I will now route the fuel line into the jerry can. With the charger supporting the car, I can now turn the ignition on and connect VCDS. In VCDS, you want to go to the engine control module. Once you head into the engine control module, you'll want to navigate to basic settings and you want to find draining fuel tank. And once you've got your hose into your jerry can, then you can press go. This module will time out after a while, so you may have to restart it. When you see the module is running, but there's no more fuel coming out of the line, that means you're ready to put the fuel line back on. The final step of the fuel draining process is to make sure that there's actually no fuel left in the lines. So we're going to run the car until it stalls out. As you can see, it's showing zero fuel and it's just stalled out. We have completely emptied the car's fuel system. Now it's time to throw in some ethanol. We've got the battery charger hooked up again, and now I'm going to give you a walkthrough of the PDM. I have turned the ignition on, and we're going to plug in the RacingLine PDM into the OBD2 port. When it's plugged in, you'll see the disco lights, and that means you're ready to connect. If you aren't familiar with how to use the RacingLine PDM, I highly recommend you check out RacingLine's video on how to do so. Once you're in the app, you want to open up the E85 tuning folder. It'll display all the relevant information as well as the E85 software release document. Make sure that you flash the correct file to match your hardware and transmission status. I completed this flash completely wirelessly using the App Connect feature on my iPhone, and it only took about 3.5 minutes. After the flash is complete, disconnect the battery charger and start it up.